In this video, we'll be looking at how to draw organic compounds in 3D for ethanol, ethanol, and ethyne. When learning organic chemistry, you will need to show the stereochemistry of chiral centers. Therefore, being able to draw the tetrahedral structures correctly is crucial. Also, you'll need to show the geometry of your substrates when drawing the mechanism. Therefore, ability to draw organic compounds in 3D is an extremely important skill. We can use either hybridization or steric number to determine the geometry for each of the atom. Let me know if you need a video on how to determine the hybridization. If you need a refresher on figuring out the steric number, refer to the Vesper geometry video. I'll link it in the description box and at the end of this video. Let's start with our first example. We're going to draw ethanol in 3D. Here is its Lewis structure, that's in 2D. These green carbons here has four groups connected to them, since they each has steric number 4 and they don't have any lone pair, that makes its geometry tetrahedral. The yellow oxygen has four groups connected to it, that means it has steric number 4, however, it also has two lone pairs, therefore the geometry for oxygen is going to be bent and not tetrahedral. So let's start with the left carbon that's tetrahedral. We'll arrange four bonds at 109.5 degrees from each other. So the first one is going to be on the same plane as the screen. We draw that as a solid line to indicate that the bond is on the same plane as our screen. The second bond is also going to be on the same plane as our screen. Therefore, we draw another solid line. Now, the remaining two bonds are going to be drawn as wedges because they're going to stick out from the plane. The one pointing behind the screen, away from us, is going to be drawn as dash wedge, and then the one pointing out of the screen towards us is going to be solid wedge. This is a regular drawing for tetrahedral geometry. Two solid lines right next to each other, and two wedges right next to each other. One of them is dash, going away from us, and one of them is solid, pointing towards us. Now we're going to add in the atoms. Since the second carbon also has tetrahedral shape, we're going to add in the second solid line, followed by the two wedges. Again, two solid lines right next to each other, and then two wedges right next to each other. That's tetrahedral. Now we're going to add in the atoms. Now the oxygen has a bent geometry. That means the bond to hydrogen should be bent, like this. And then we add in the lone pairs. And we're done. So you might be wondering, earlier when we draw the solid line for the second carbon, why did we draw it pointing up? Is it okay to draw it pointing down? Well, the answer is yeah. To do so, all we have to do is rotate the CC bond like that. So everything to the left, we'll just keep it as is. And then we're going to rotate the bond on the second carbon. Now the solid line, we're going to draw it pointing down. We'll draw the two wedges pointing up. So now we still have a tetrahedral. It's just that the bonds are oriented differently. We fill in the atoms and we're done. Both of this drawing is going to be acceptable. It just depends on how you want to present your structure. For our second example, let's draw ethanol in 3D. Ethanol is an aldehyde. So this is its Lewis structure. The green carbon here has four groups connected to it. So that's going to be tetrahedral. The pink carbon has three groups connected to it. So its steric number is going to be 3 with 0 lone pair, so that makes its shape triangular. Now we're going to start drawing the pink carbon that's triangular. We'll arrange the three bonds at 120 degrees from each other, and then we're going to add in the atoms. Since the green carbon has tetrahedral shape and we already have one solid line, we're going to continue on drawing the other solid line because we should have two bonds right next to each other on the same plane. And then the other two bonds are going to be perpendicular to that. One bond sticking backwards away from us, dash wedge, and the solid wedge pointing towards us. We add in the hydrogens and we're done. For our final example, let's draw ethyne. Here is the Lewis structure for ethyne. This green carbon has four groups, so therefore it's tetrahedral. Now the blue carbons, they have two groups connected to it and no lone pair. So therefore, the geometry for those two blue carbons are going to be linear. Let's start with the two carbons that are linear. So we place hydrogen at the end. And then now let's connect the green carbon to our two carbons. So carbon 3 We're going to add it in here. Now that green carbon already has one bond drawn to it that's on the same plane. So we need to draw another bond right next to it that's also on the same plane at 109.5. And then the other two bonds in wedges, one pointing to the back and one pointing to the front. So that's a tetrahedral shape. Two solid lines next to each other, two wedges next to each other. And then we fill in with the atom and we're done drawing ethyne in 3D. Quick recap, here are the three organic compounds that we've just drawn in 3D. Basically, linear, triangular, and bent geometries will all have their bonds on the same plane. Tetrahedral, on the other hand, are going to have two bonds on the same plane and then another two sticking out of the plane. The one pointing behind the plane is drawn as dash wedge. The one pointing to the front of the plane is going to be drawn as solid wedge. With that, we're done going through how to draw organic compounds in 3D. I have more videos in this series, so do check out the links in the description box below. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.